Minasan, konnichiwa, Zamora Engineer Des. In this lesson number 7 of chapter 12, we will again compare the procedures for the statement of cash flows under GAAP and IFRS. So let us first talk about the similarities between the two companies. Prepare financial statements under IFRS must prepare a statement of cash flow as an integral part of financial statements. They are similar with this. Both of them require that statement of cash flows should have three major sections: operating, investing, and financing, along with changes in cash and cash equivalents. They are the same. Similar to GAAP, the cash flow statement can be prepared using either indirect or direct method under IFRS. In both US and international settings, companies choose for the most part to use indirect method for reporting net cash flows from operating activities. Straightforward. I think straightforward is the account. The account, the use worksheet. But you can choose one only because the account that is already what using worksheet. You don't need to double the recording and the preparation of report activities. But anyway, this is the realities on the ground. The definition of cash equivalents used in IFRS is similar to that used in GAAP. A major difference is that in certain situations, bank overdrafts are considered part of cash and cash equivalent under IFRS. So, bank overdraft, which is not the case in GAAP. That is not part of cash and cash equivalents. Then, how to account for this in our cash flow? So, there is some difference. Under GAAP, bank overdrafts are classified as financial activities in the statement of cash flows and are reported as liabilities on the balance sheet. Overdraft liabilities, bank overdrafts. Okay, so we will have more discussion about that later. Differences. IFRS requires that non-cash investing and financing activities be excluded from statement of cash flows. Okay. Non-cash investing and financing. Instead, these non-cash activities should be reported elsewhere. This requirement is interpreted to mean that non-cash investing and financing activities should be disclosed in the notes to the financial statements instead of in the financial statements. Notes. Remember the notes. Financial statements, they are the main focus of the report. And in the lower portion, there are several notes. Notation. Okay. The explaining some of the things like this in particular. Okay, what particular to be explained? For example, disclosure on land, on acquiring of land by using bonds. For example, that is in our example in this chapter. Second one, this is the what non-cash investing and financing activities. So, if that is not included in your cash flow, then put that as a note below the financial statement reports. Under GAAP, companies may present this information on the face of the statement cash flow. Face, on the face of the statement cash flow. We have the option. One area where there can be substantial difference between IFRS and GAAP relates to the classification of interest, dividends, and taxes. The following table indicates the differences between the two approaches. For example, item, interest paid. IFRS will first take note, then GAAP second. So, interest paid, operating or financing. GAAP, operating. Interest received, operating or investing, GAAP operating. So dividends paid, operating or financing, GAAP financing. So GAAP is rules based. It has a specific rules. It is a, there's no room for what? Flexibility and so there is one set of rules. That's it. That is GAAP. Dividends received, operating or investing, GAAP, operating. Taxes paid, operating, and a specific identification with financing or investing activities. So, GAAP, operating. Is that the common difference? Under IFRS, some companies present the operating section in a single line item with full reconciliation provided in the notes to the financial statement. This presentation is not seen under GAAP. Operating section in a single line item. Wow. Okay. Recently, the standards boards of both of these standards are involved in joint project on presentation and organization of information in financial statements. Interesting approach revealed in a published proposal from the project is that in the future, the income statement and balance sheet could adopt headings similar to those of the statement of cash flows. That is, the income statement and balance sheet would be broken into operating, investing in financing section. So that we can lessen the amount of reports already there at once. So that's, I think, one good thing. Unless we can miss out on some information. I don't know right now how to react with this, but since they are trying to talk about common interest, and they are the expert on this field, they are the expert, they are standards governing bodies, so I think they know what they are doing. I don't know the implication of this right now. And now let us go to the section where we test our understanding of IFRS. Under IFRS, interest paid can be reported as A, only a financing element, B, a financing element or an investing element, C, financing element or operating element, and D, only an operating element. So obviously, we just explained this out. Three slides ago, the answer is financing element or an operating element. So unlike in GAAP, interest paid is only operating element. Number two, IFRS requires that non-cash items be reported in the section to which they relate. That is, non-cash investing activity would be reported in the investing section. B, disclosed in the notes to the financial statements. C, do not need to be reported. D, be treated in the fashion similar to cash equivalent. This is actually B, disclosed in the notes to the financial statement. Non-cash items. Number three, in the future, it appears likely that A, income statement and balance sheet will have headings of operating, investing, and financing, much like the statement of cash flows. B, cash and cash equivalents will be combined in a single line item. C, the ISAB will not allow companies to use the direct approach to the statement of cash flows. D, none of the above. So the answer is actually A. Okay, so thank you very much. Please don't forget to patronate and subscribe to our channel. Please like, share, and subscribe. Again, this is Dr. AP, Preaching Engineering for Nation Building.